Hi guys, namaste. Thanks for tuning into AI Probably. And this is Harshit Agarwal. And we are currently in the part 2 of our Django course. In this particular part, we'll be learning about how to deploy our machine learning models using Django. In this particular part, we'll be seeing how to create a model, how to link the model with a Django app, and then defining the URLs, paths, and links to the views. After that, we'll see how to work with JSON files and how to run the Django app. And in the last, we'll be using the created API in a web app using Streamlit. So let's get started.
So enough of the theory part. Let's move on to how to deploy machine learning models with Django. So just as always, before deploying the machine learning model, we need to have a machine learning model. So here I have a machine learning model ready for a Titanic dataset. So for those of you who do not know what Titanic dataset is, it is all about the Titanic ship actually. So using some attributes like the class of the ticket which the person was in, or the age of the person, the sex of the person, the fare of the ticket of the person, and on what port he or she was at that time. So using all these attributes, we'll be predicting whether the person was able to survive the Titanic massacre or not. So first things first, we'll be importing all the required libraries. This includes NumPy, Pandas, Seaborn, Matplotlib, Plotly, and then we'll be importing some models from it like random forest classifier, decision tree, and others. So we have the dataset with us and we'll be reading it using pd.read.csv. Then we can just have a little information about our dataset, and we can see that there are few null values in my dataset. So we can see that age has 714 non-null entries, while the total number of entries is 891. So there are obviously some null entries in age column. Same goes for cabin and embarked. So first of all, we need to do some data cleansing and data pre-processing to make this data not null. Okay, so to do that, first we need to know how the data is dependent on each other. So first we need to see how age is actually affecting the chances of a person being survived or not. So here is a graph. The first one is for females and second one is for males. The blue lines here says survived and the red one says not survived. So what we can see here is the chances of females surviving if they are between an age of, let's say, 13 to 40 are pretty high. But the opposite is almost same for the males. So the chances of males surviving the Titanic are high only if they are like between 25 to 30. So using this information, we can see how the age is affecting the chances of survival. And we can see, yes, age is definitely a major factor in both males and females, and it does affect the chances of their survival. The next attribute what we want to see is the P class. So P class is the class of passengers, passenger class, which is 1, 2, 3, and first class being obviously the highest class, then the second and then the third. So what we can see is the average survival rate of the class 1 is obviously the highest, and then goes the second class and then the third class. So P class obviously does affect the survival rate a lot. And then we see how the SIB SP feature is affecting the survival rate. So the survival rate is pretty high for the SIB SP value of 0 to 3, but after that it is pretty low. So yeah, by the way, the SIB SP represents the number of siblings. Okay, so after that, we need to move on to the data cleansing part, and we'll be removing the cabin column completely, and we do not actually need the passenger ID column also. So we'll be dropping all these columns, and after that we'll be filling the embarked column, all the null values in the embarked column with S, and we'll be filling the age with the mean age. And now we can see how our data is looking. So now we can see that there are no null values in the data, but there is still one null value in the test data, which is in fare. So we'll just fill it with 0. So after doing that, now we have a clean test set and a clean training set. After that, we'll be mapping all the object values or the string values to the integer class. So like we have sex here as male or female, so we'll be mapping it to zeros and ones, 0 being the male and 1 being the female. Same will be done for the embarked and for the names. So for names, what we'll be doing is we'll be just taking the title of names. So if it is Mr., Mrs., or Miss., or something, or master. So we'll be first mapping the titles to Mr., Miss., Mrs., Master, or something else like Captain, Lady, or Countess, or something. So after mapping the names, we'll be removing the names column and we'll be adding another column named as title. Once this is done, we'll be mapping the sex, that is male and female, to binaries also, like zeros and ones. After that, we'll be mapping the embarked column and we are ready. So after that, we'll be defining the x and y vectors, and after that, we'll be testing it on our model. So first model which we are taking here is the random forest classifier, and the random forest classifier gives us a score of 98.43. Then we check for the decision tree classifier, and the decision tree classifier also gives us the score of 98.43. After that, we'll be exporting this particular model using Pickle library, and that's pretty much it for the model. So now that we have a model with us, we can move on to linking this particular model to the Django app itself. So I hope you guys remember that we created a project named Model API, and we created an app inside that with the name of API. So this is pretty much it, and now let's move on to the project itself. So this is how the structure is, and let's just ignore these extra folders that we have here, like templates and models. So to link the model with the Django app, first we need to save this model inside a models folder inside the application itself. So the application is API, and I have a folder named models inside which I have copied my model, which I just now exported using Pickle. After that, we need to move on to settings.py file, and first of all, we need to describe, or we need to enter our app's name in the installed apps list. After that, we need to define the models path using models equals os.path.join base directory API/model, that is the path to the models folder. And after that, we need to move on to the apps.py file where we'll be loading this particular model using this particular code. So in this code, I'm just opening the Pickle model using the Pickle library itself, and I'll be storing the model in a variable named as model. So which will be, we'll be using this particular variable, this particular model variable, to actually predict the values. Now we'll be moving on to the URLs file. So in the URLs file, you again just ignore these two parts. We'll be talking about these two parts in the further sessions. So currently we'll be focusing on this particular path. This admin path comes by default, so you need not worry about that. This is just for some admin access. If you want to give some admin special access in your website, so you can just define that here. Django gives it by default. After that, we'll be moving to defining another path which starts with predict. So after the base URL, which would be 127.0.01:800, that is the port number, 8000, sorry. So after that, if the user writes predict, so that is taken as another URL path. So if the user is writing predict, then I want to take it to the class, which is call model, that I have been defined in the views.py file. And it will be transferring that particular request to call model class. So let's see what is in the call model class actually. So this is the call model class which I have created here. And in this, what I'm doing is, if the user has given the URL as /predict, so after that, the user has to define something known as P class, sex, age, CivSP, parch, fair, embarked, and title. So all these information the user has to give inside the URL only, which will constitute the whole API part of the application. And we'll be getting these information and we'll be storing it into the variables. After doing that, we'll be creating a list of all these variables, or the attributes actually. And thereafter, the model which we just now imported from the Pickle in our apps.py file, we'll be simply using that model dot predict function, and we'll be providing the data itself, and we'll be storing the prediction here. So if the prediction is equals to 0, that means the person has not survived. Else, if the prediction is equals to 1, the prediction would be that the person has survived. So defining that, we'll be returning a response to the user. And since we'll be working with JSON here, JSON response here, so first we need to create a dictionary, or what we can say, a data frame named response, and we'll be, so dictionary named response, which will be having passenger status, and the value of this passenger status key would be the prediction itself. After that, we'll be returning the JSON response, to the user. This JSON response is nothing but this particular thing. So in the case of APIs, if you are getting some results like this, this means that it is a JSON file and not something else. So this is not a web page. This is a JSON file which is displayed on the browser. So you can always just download this JSON file and you can use the content or the values from this particular JSON file in your application easily. We'll also be diving into that part, into how to do that thing in few slides later. So that was it for linking the model with the Django app. And we have successfully linked the Django app with the model, or sorry, we have successfully linked the model with the Django app. So while linking our model with the Django app, we saw how to define the URLs, the paths, and how to link them to views, where we created the call model class. After that, we also saw how to work with JSON files and how to return a response as JSON. Now, the only thing remaining is running the Django app. So before running the Django app, I really would suggest you to make this particular command run, which is python manage.pymigrate, which helps to migrate the database. So Django does it itself. You need not go into the depth of it, but it is really an important command to perform before actually deploying your app. And after you have migrated the database successfully, you just need to provide python manage.py run server to run the app itself. So this is how it will look. And as you can see here, after the predict, we have defined p class and sex, age, civsv, parch, fair, embarked, and title. So using the logic defined earlier, the application would extract these fields, the p class, sex, age, and all these fields, and it will provide it to the model, and the model would predict, and thereafter it would store the response in the response dictionary which we created, and it will be returned to us as a JSON response which says passenger status is equals to not survive. So here we have some other attributes other than these. So for these particular attributes, we can see that the passenger status is survived. So after doing this, we now know that our model is successfully linked with the Django app and the Django app is running successfully. We now have a API using which we can actually access our model. The next step is we would be using this particular API to create a web app using Streamlit. So this is the Streamlit application which I have defined, or which I just now showed you in the look at the project section of this course. So this is the coding for the Streamlit web application. Here I would only be taking you through the using the API part. So that is, we'll be defining the URL. So this is nothing but I actually hosted that particular app onto Heroku using the name titanicpredictorweb.herokuapp.com. Don't worry about this, we'll be getting to this part also pretty soon. So after defining the base URL, we'll be writing predict, and after that we'll be writing p class, and we'll be giving the value of p class, then sex, age, civsp, parsed, fair, embarked, and title. So after defining the URL, we'll be performing a get request on the URL, and we'll be getting the JSON response and only extracting the value of the key passenger status. So like that we can store the prediction which we have got from the model. So this is how we can use our created model API in any of the applications. So this is just a demo of Streamlit application, but if you want, you can use it on your Android application, on your iOS application, or some other web application like that. So let me just show you a quick review of the Streamlit application. So this is the Streamlit application where we have three different pages, which says home, predict, and explore the data. So the home page just shows a quick review about the data set, and it shows an image. It says that choose pages from the navigation toggle. So if we go to predict, we just have these user inputs where we can select the p class, and as soon as I select the p class to be one, it will show me the other inputs to enter. So let's select the sex as female, and let's enter the age as 38, and the civsp as 1, parch as 0, the fair would be 71.28, we can select the embarked as C, and the title as Mrs. So after providing all these inputs, we can see that the model predicted that yes, the passenger survived. So similarly, we can just change these inputs to anything and we can see whether the person would survive or not. And the third and last page in this application is the explore the dataset part, where we have some interactive graphs with us, and all these graphs are the same which I showed you in the model itself. And all these graphs just tell us about the age and sex dependence on the survival, P-class dependence on the survival, and CBSP dependence on the survival. And it also shows the initial data, what initial data we had, so the summary of the initial data, and how our cleaned data or the final data looks like. So this was pretty simple app, which had just one functionality to predict whether the user would survive or not. So in this particular prediction method, we have used the API which we just now created using Django and linking our model with it.
Alright guys, so this was it for this particular part, and I will meet you in the next part of this particular course. Till then, please stay tuned to the channel and please subscribe the channel if you haven't done it already, and also hit the bell icon to get the latest updates from AI Probably.